What's up? What's up? Welcome, welcome. Oh, sorry, I forgot to update the day, but today I'll be working on more alpha high priority items. Let me update this little title. Oh, it's day 227. Whoa. Whoa, we're getting up above half a year, closer to a year. So crazy. I can't believe it's this been this far already. What the heck am I working on today? This stuff, what is this? Retain the area. Some more alpha bug fixes. What's up, JFK? Jonah? Welcome, you guys. Hopefully this is a better stream for y'all, because it's a little bit earlier. Yeah, right on. Nice. Nice. Yeah, Pedro, what's up? Better for most of y'all, I think. I'm always shooting to get these early streams in, but I never seem to. But today's one of those days where I did. Amazing. Amazingness. So what I worked on this morning was getting the boss encounters to be a little better for when you. Yeah, Coin, what's up? What's up, you guys? So the boss encounters are way better. So I can like turn off the compass and stuff. And I'll get both of these boss encounters. And if I die during one of the boss encounters, I can get that encounter again. So that was a bug a second ago was if you die during the boss encounter, like if I die, I'm just gonna instantly die here. And then continue. That used to be a bug where I would never be able to encounter that boss again, but now it's all good and you can encounter the boss. Look at this. Oh, look at this boss fight. Yeah, so that's another thing on the list here is to get the boss fights so they always occur where there's enough free space. Because that would be kind of weird, especially what would be really suck is if you got on a screen like this and the boss was all the way in the top left and you're in the bottom right and there's no way to get to him. So you would be essentially locked there by the gates and it would be impossible to beat that boss. So yeah, little improvements like that. What's up? Marza, Alex Pita. Oh, we got a triple dipple going on. So what am I gonna work on first? Oh yeah, I'm gonna try this. Retaining the area so the scene doesn't crash on exit. Oh, oh, quintuple. Six. Sextuple. We need a septuple. Come on. Oh, come on, somebody. I know it's early in the stream though. So I'm gonna put the player at the very beginning. All they have is the teleport. Oh man, everybody's like doesn't want to chat because they don't want to ruin it. That's so funny. Oh, is it gonna happen? I don't know. I don't know if anybody else knows. It's so early. We've only been streaming for like 5 minutes. Seven. Here we go. So the player all the way beginning. Oh, eight. Oh my God. This is almost the record. I think the record's nine. Last night it was nine. Wow. Wait, is that seven? Wait. Oh, we got seven. Seven, sorry. How did this start? Such a silly little thing, but it's so entertaining. Yeah, so I'm gonna do something really simple. Oh, that's a niner. Niner right there. I'm taking a screenshot because that's equal to the biggest one we've ever had. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. If one other person does it right now, we will have a 10. That will be a world record. I don't think this has ever been done on Twitch before, to my knowledge. Because we're the only people. Oh! We got a 9 though. 9, that's the record. We equaled the record. Yeah, it's enough. It's enough. It's definitely good. No worries, no worries. No, no banning him. No banning. Yeah, you're ban happy. There'll be tons of bots today, I'm telling you. Close to the, it is the, yeah, equal to the world record. Equal to the world record. We didn't quite break it. No, no, no. Yeah, only one record per day. It totally kills the chat for a minute, right? Yeah. But it sure is fun. You know what? I think this might fix this crash on exit bug. So what happens is I create an area scene once for the game. This is a statically initialized scene, and then I also init it, set a tag. I think retaining it is going to prevent it from releasing it at the wrong moment in time. So, well, how I can check this is whenever he talks, whenever there's dialogue in the game and you exit the game, it crashes usually. So hopefully this retain here will fix that. So all I gotta do is let it do some stuff. What's up, Momir? A pink wig is coming my way. That would be great. No dialogue. Oh, because I have the sword already. Okay, no sword. No evil awakening. No teleport pause. No, none of this either. We just want to go straight up like this. Oh, I'm doing fabulous too. Doing some BC Warrior myself. No, oh, it still crashed. Dang. See, it's these font atlases. They get Sprite Kit. It's a child of sprites. Sprite node vector. Label. Yeah, it's 9. Yeah, it's pretty awesome, right? Let me prove that. There it is. Boom. 9 of them. All your names will go down in history, especially when we get to 10. You know what? This is really not that important. It's a crash on exit. So I'm gonna put this as a low priority item. Alright. Yeah, let's get on to this next one. Compass Zero shouldn't play the invalid noise. So that's a new noise I added that plays this like invalid sound when you use something that you shouldn't be. Hello, Pashti. Welcome. Welcome, welcome, welcome. I think what's going on, let's give the player the compass. And the sword and stuff. Yeah, just the compass, I guess. Yeah, we'll give the player the sword, too. Oh, yeah, that would be so sweet. Oh, my God. Yeah, I got to put this on the ideas list, because that's awesome. Oh, yeah, what are they? What are the Slovak characters? So, yeah, I got German characters, Italian characters I have to add. What are the Slovak characters? Let me know, and I'll get these in there, too. Yeah, totally cool Easter egg. And Pedro, are there any special characters I need for Portuguese that are not on this list here? Why am I not in the closet today? I'm still in another closet. But yeah, I'm in a different room of our place because we have a guest over. So yeah, I'm in our in the other room today. Right, so I'm pretty sure let's just use the compass. I'm always verifying things, right? Verify we still have the problem. Okay, so what happens when I release the key? Yeah. So I'm pretty sure all I need to do is give. There's these input components have their repeat count. And I'm doing this a lot. I need to make a simple function. This right here. When you set a timer. Oh, okay, squigglies. Thank you, thank you. All right, cool. Be drawing these. Seconds. Wow. Whoa. This function, yeah, we need to make this a function. Input component. Oh, we already got it. Set timers. Yeah, it's solely, right? So we need to set, we have set timers and a set timer. Set timer, timer. Yours is 15? You're in Brazil. Marza has like crazy internet over there. Whoa, there's a lot of crazy ones. So is this DZ one character? Or is that two? Thanks. That just D? Oh, right. Portugal. Sorry. Sorry. I know. So bad of me, right? Yes, Pashti, it already runs on Windows. Yep. It's coming out for Windows and Mac, the alpha version next, or yeah, this next Wednesday. Yeah, but the person, thankfully, Mightiness, he's one of the people on the stream here. He's one translating it into Japanese. Him and his wife, they're doing it. So, he's actually drawing all the kanji. So, yeah, I gave him the font and he's going to town. So, good for him. That's awesome. Okay, so the DZ is exactly one character. And this L, is that also one character? Oh, yeah. Okay, I can see that's one character. But this is separate. This is like two characters on my thing. Is there a Unicode character that actually represents this DZ? I'd like to be able to have one character for that. What is this? Oh, there, whoops. Okay, so it looks like it's just it. Oh, see, this is one character here. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so yeah, I'll copy this guy. Oh yeah, that's right. That's right. Yeah, you gotta get to know this guy. You probably would have some in common. Whoa, look at that. It squishes them together. Squish, squish. Well, that's really weird to see that as Unicode. So I'll do all three of these, I guess. Wait, should I do all three of these, JFK? Because I could just do the Z, and then you could put a D and a Z, and it'd probably be simpler, right? Oh, good point. Good point. Yeah. Oh, that's only Spain. Oh, cool. But I do need to do this for Spanish. Because I'm going to have Spanish at some point. Even if I translate it myself. Even though I don't really speak Spanish, I can read it. Sort of. There's the Ñ. Ñ. Alright, so what's up? Compass Zero. Oh, yeah. I'm going to finish this. Okay, cool. All right, so what I'm going to do when I when you translate it, yeah, just use the D plus the Z, and I'll only create this Z. So I'm not actually going to create that special character, which is a combo. I'm just going to put a note there. I'm not using those. Ñ, yeah. Did you already put the Ñ in here? Oh, yep. Ñ. Thanks. Lots of stuff to draw. That's going to take a while to draw all those, but yeah. It'll be worth it. So far I've gotten German translation from German and Italian, so... there's no hurry at all to get these translation files neither, but, cause they're all going to change, you know, by the time the game's released, it's all going to be different, but, this alpha version will at least have, German and Italian. Yeah. 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 Cool. All right. So awesome. Good stuff. So this is just, yeah, we're just going to set the timer to whatever and then increase the repeat count. Yeah. Oh, Pashti, yeah. Well, This is why a lot of developers will use game engines that are already written, cross-platform game engines. This is a big reason why I use Cocos 2DX, because they already do all that for me. And I've done this before. I've written my own games. This was before the OpenGL days. I mean, this is back all the way in DOS. In DOS, we had to totally write our own game engines. You had to write your own functions to even get the time from the system clock, causing an interrupt in the system. And getting, like, just setting the video mode. You had to set your video mode to either 320 by 240 or 640 by 480. But 640 by 480 only had 16 colors or something crazy. So if you wanted 256 color, you had to use 320 by 240, which is a tiny res, like the Nintendo. So that was back in the day. So I know what you mean about creating your own game engine. And, yeah, I would totally recommend using a nice open source game engine like Cocos 2DX or SDL or something like that. But if you're at the place where you want to create your own engine and that's your thing, then all the power to you, man. Just take a then if you really do want to write your own engine, just take a look at how Cocos 2DX, for example, creates the initial app on all these different platforms. Cause yeah, it is totally different on each platform. You have to do things a little bit differently. OpenGL is mostly the same, but initializing your game is different. So, yeah, R2. What's up, R2? Yeah, SDL. Definitely. Yeah, Alpha's coming out. What's up, Byer Kogan? All right, so back to the list, Input component, set timer. This is this convenience method. We don't have to redo this all the time. This thing sets a timer. Oh, this also needs the int index. If index is less than k, num equipables, or is greater than or equal to, and bogus, retrun. So index, timer duration. Let's make that clear in this in the header. So these timers for the input basically cause the input to pop to not allow any more input for a little while. So if you set the timer for the input, it ticks down that timer, and after the timer's done, then you can do some more input. So I've been repeating this bit of code so much, I'm like, dude, I gotta make this a function. There. So now we've got that. Let's compile that. It also, I've also got this mechanism for repeating input. So you'd be able to hold down your button and repeat up to the repeat max. So right now I've got all pretty much everything only has a repeat max of 1. So basically you press the button and you have to let go of the button and then press it again to be able to use your item or sword or whatever again. But I designed this so maybe you'd be able to have an item or whatever that would allow you to repeat your sword attack. So you'd hold it down and you'd swing twice. Oh. Yeah, you use SDL? Cool. Oh, yeah. No, man, no, definitely don't be sorry for moaning, because this is something we need to solve. As game developers, it's good for us to talk about these things, because if we can solve these and not have to moan anymore, then hell yeah, let's do something about it. I really like Jonathan Blow's spirit of creating his new programming language. It's supposed to make things easier for game developers. So, actually, I'm gonna be taking more and more of a look at his language, because, you know, once it reaches maturity and it's ready, then, man, it's almost tempting to rewrite this game in it, but I probably wouldn't, because I already have how many lines now? 37,000? How did I write 600 lines of code in a week? Jeez. Oh. Oh, right. Oh, I didn't know SDL was that friendly. That's cool. Here we go. Here's a great example of where to use this. E.input.setTimer. Index I. Whoa. I. Duration 0.5. Here's another one. E.input, set timer. Yep. Using the bomb, using the sword, or the ghost sword. Here's the one. Yeah, each one of these I'm just scanning over to make sure I didn't make a mistake. Yeah, here's another one, fire orb. But anyways, I'm building this up so that I can use this for this, for using the compass even, which will make it, I think, so the compass doesn't... Actually, let's throw it right in here if we're at the use compass function. Use that a map and compass. These should both... Oh, it already does have a... Oh, but it didn't... See, it didn't use the function, which increases the repeat count, which enables you to not play that invalid sound. All right, that should help those. Use that a blink. Six 619. Used to live in that area code, zip code, area code, phone area code. Different order of RGB values on Windows and OS X. Whoa. Ah, cool. I'm so glad you're able to help him, R2. Because I haven't used SDL myself, so I don't know if that's a actual issue with SDL, like they didn't provide that. I would assume that SDL would provide some kind of function for that. Cactus duration. These are where we test. Cool, let's do another test for dot repeat. All right, let's test this out. Oh. Huh. Oh, yeah, so you're talking about reading textures shader. Was that in your shader or was that in your texture? Like when you're reading the texture in your shader or reading the texture in your actual SDL or in your game's code. All right, so we should be set up for this again. Compass 2, ready to use it. This time it shouldn't play the invalid noise. Yeah, cool, it didn't. Let's play that again one more time. Yes, very good. Fix the problem. This time I'm gonna do it one more time and hold down the button a long time. So it gets past that timer duration. Now I'm letting go. Still doesn't play it. Good. So that was definitely had to do with that repeat count. Bam! Bug off the list. See ya. Get integer. Ah. Good, man. I'm so glad I wrote this function. It's so good to just simplify things and have a... Everywhere you see the same code, it's like, why the hell are you... Why haven't you written a function for this, Mr. Programmer? Mr. Me? All right, next thing on the list. Enemies should never continue walking towards an edge. This is kind of really important because, man, it makes enemies look so dumb when they're just they just sit there walking against the edge of a room. And it's because they're using random directions when they hit an edge, they choose a new random direction. But that random direction can possibly be against the edge again. Ah. Yeah. Yeah, definitely. These guys are definitely to thank for this. I hope that helps you, man. I hope that solves your issue or kind of puts you in the right path to solving it, you know? Sometimes it's just that, you know, that one little impetus, that bit of impulse or whatever to get you on the right path that helps you solve your problem, you know? Here we go. These guys will work. 3, 2, 1. We have the sword. Let's give the player the top hat, too. There's a classic example. That guy on the top just keeps walking over and over and over and over. Okay, so here's my idea for when an enemy gets up there, the system is in the behavior system. Okay, behavior if stuck dir rands. Okay, behavior dir. And not if dir is, but set dir. Yeah. I'll let that person say. yeah, we had two worlds actually that were we had fart and poopy. And poopy turned out to be crazy, but only because I had it was actually very awesome to do poopy because Poopy turned out to be this world where I had these bugs and found these bugs, solved the bugs. Now it's all good. Poopy's actually a cool world now, but it was kind of bad. Oh, Dodgeball, you're talking about the room. Yeah, I'm in a different room today. We have a guest over, so I'm in a different room. So still coding in a closet, though. I got my setup at the top of a closet. The only difference is my keyboard's on a guitar. You do Poopy almost every day. Oh, man. Don't we all? So, Durand. I think this is the thing. Yeah. Okay. So, this is my idea, is if we ever do a Durand, it should prefer directions that are based on the character's current quadrant. So if a character is up in the upper right quadrant, for example, the two directions it should choose from randomly should be left or down. You know, it's a simple way to do it, but it ought to fix it. Let's see. Dude, I didn't know this was... Nice. No, I haven't. Songbringer on it? Yeah, anyways, Songbringer is already on the Humble Bundle and the Humble Bundle store. They're just kind of waiting to promote it because it's you know, it's not going to be released till whatever. So I think Humble Bundle is going to put some more energy into it when it's closer to being released. So yeah, so I mean definitely I'm keeping my eye on this too. But if you happen to see Songbringer get on this list, let me know, because I'm not always aware of everything that's going on. Yeah, yeah, yep. I know it's that, but Songbringer might actually be one of these monthly Humble Bundle things. Is what I was saying. Because it's on Humble Bundle as a widget, It's also on the Humble Bundle store. So there's a Humble Bundle store thing, and that's related to the Humble Bundle monthly thing. Wow, so this is a bit of archaic code right here. It's checking if the valid position. Life goals, get a game on Humble Bundle. Dude, you can do it. You could do it, man. It's definitely, wasn't that hard. Wasn't that hard for at least for this. I'd recommend building up your game a bit, right? Build it up to the point where it looks cool. You're getting people more and more interested. And the whole time you're building your prototype or your alpha or whatever you want to call it, your preview version of your game, your demo, that whole time, make sure you're building up a following for it too somehow, you know, whether you're sharing on whatever social network you're doing, just build up that following and then get, and then do something to get a lot of attention that really helps to like launch a Kickstarter or something like that, that can get you so much attention. Or just dropping your game on Greenlight on Steam. And what that's going to do is going to get articles written and stuff like that. You have so much like good energy put into your game that way from the industry. And then Humble Bundle, it's like it's really easy to get on Humble Bundle at that point. But I think you could get on Humble Bundle even without that. Like Humble, all you got to do is apply for Humble Bundle. Robot voice. all you gotta do is apply for Humble Bundle. It's really, and once you get approved for their widget, then it's only one more step to get approved for the store as well. Oh no, was it me? Marza, am I okay? Is it okay now? Oh, I got some drop frames. It might have been my end. But it looks like I'm still streaming all right. Cool. Jay was translating. Nice. Yeah, he was helping us out. What's up, King? Nothing. I'm tempted to comment this out right here. Yeah, I'm going to try this. Because I'm going to do something else. This is janky code too. Let's rewrite all this. I see. Well, if not the current game, then I know I respect your life goal, dude. That's awesome. So, maybe your next game. And by the way, everyone, I'm really would love to see what you're creating. So if you're on the stream, you know, share your screenshots, share your links to your games you're working on. I love rooting for you guys. It's cool because, you know, I don't really have any friends that are game developers, except for, you know, I have very few, maybe one other friend, actual, you know, life friend that I grew up with or whatever, that's a game developer. So how does Humble Bundle pay? I was going to say slowly, but yeah, basically, you either get your widget on there, right? So like on songbringer.com, I'm using their widget, like on the pre-order, you either get the widget or you're on their store. And then basically they just pay you on a monthly basis, a percentage and all that. cool. Oh, wow. All right, so if the player is in, or if the, this entity, it's gonna be kind of like this. The player, it's gonna detect the quadrant of the current entity and then return a couple directions that are possible and then choose from them. I didn't know this either. That's cool. Yeah, he's still a game developer. Yeah, that's what I was talking about. That's my childhood friend. He's writing a book right now. Yeah. Stoked for him. He's always been an author, so, you know, he's writing it. He's a very creative guy. Sweet. Yeah. Happy face game. Nice, man. What's it called? What's the concept? True skill. Is there any money really made through that? I don't know. It's a really good question. I haven't actually been on that whole monthly bundle thing yet, so I can't really say. I've only made some money through my actual pre-orders of the game for the widget. So, and it's been very low amounts of money compared to doing a Kickstarter, for example. So, yeah. And none of it's profit. All of this is going into this game, this developing this game. So, yeah. Oh, right on. Okay, so is this an engine or a tool that you're working on? Like this? This is all stuff you've written, this whole tool? So we're going to create a list of possible directions. Make them tools. Ah. Is what you're working on, Pashy? Sweet. I love it. Personally, it's like I love retro. I love pixel art so much. Cool shader you got on here too. Looks like you almost have like a little brick or paper type of texture on everything. And then you got this cool shadow around everything. Nice work, man. Nice work. I really want to see some light coming out of this light thing here. Cool, dude. I am random guy number 59034541004. Nice. Sweet, dude. I'll have to check out your stuff more of it later on. So this is a tool you're writing. Sweet. Sweet. All right, so we're going to get the entity's current position. And if it's in the upper quadrant, or say upper left, we've got two possibilities. Yeah, no, that's not cheating. That's definitely not cheating. That's how a lot of games do it these days, right? They just throw an alpha blended overlay on top of your scene and it looks cool. For example, a great game that I played on mobile actually was Icicle. So great. And it really uses this, what the heck is this? Icicle. Oh, I spelled it wrong. Here we go, by Damp Nat. Yeah, this guy's a great one-man game development studio. I forget his name, but he's really cool. And Icicle uses this effect kind of too. They just use an alpha blended type thing, type of texture on top. But if you've never played this game, I highly recommend it. See, look at that. See that texture? Yeah. Great game, by the way. I'm gonna post a link here. Oh, cool. Yeah. Oh, nice, nice. Is this SDL? Does this, oh, yeah. Nice. Is this like a, you're dropping off, troopers and are these bombs? Is this a single screen? Like you're fighting against anti-aircraft, or are you actually flying across this and scrolling? Mm-hmm. Like paratrooper, right? Yeah, totally. Oh, it is Kogosuri. Ah. Oh, you're the cannon. Right, right. Okay, yeah. So we'll make half width. Easy size dot width and half height, also really easy. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, cool. I remember playing a similar one too. I totally forget what it was called. So this is a lower left quadrant, and this is gonna, we're gonna push back two things. Oh, we also need to make sure this is gonna be three directions actually. Yeah. Oh, cool. Really? Whoa, it was illegal? Okay, come. So if we're in the lower left, we can go north. North, east. Or east. tribute. I'm just turning off that sound just in case YouTube flags my video. Cool physics. Yay. I like it. I like this background too. Are those eyeballs? What are those? So you're just kind of demoing physics and stuff? Oh, whoa. Oh my god, this reminds me of... Oh! Yeah! Break-breaking game. Nice balls. deterministic physics. Attaboy. Yes. Yeah. Deterministic physics. Bam. Yeah, if anybody's wondering why the heck that would be good, deterministic means you would be able to run it in a multiplayer environment, and it would run the same on whatever platform you're on or whatever. Yeah, basically, that's the goal, is for your game to run the same every time, even though it appears random or appears to be physically natural, you know? Sweet. This is cool. Looks like a spherical Rubik's Cube. This is inspiration right here. You could use that for so much. You could write a whole game around something like this. Fiend! Finito! Sweet. Nice work, man. Yeah, I can tell you got some great skills. So now we'll do upper left. That's if pause.y is greater than or equal to h2. We're gonna be able to go south, southeast, or east. Now we'll do lower right or upper right. Oh man, I'm telling you, the thing to do if you really want to start getting more likes and stuff, just start sharing your stuff more, you know. That's because I was in the same kind of position before I started this game. I had no clue how to market. I didn't know how to build a following for my game or whatever. But I just started with Twitter. You know, I started by exploring social networks until I was like, all right, I kind of like, you know what, I really actually really love Twitter, especially compared to like Facebook and stuff. So, but anyways, yeah, I started getting more and more and more likes just the more I shared. Because my Songbringer, if you look back at the very first day on my videos on YouTube or whatever, you see I had barely anyone following me on the stream. So there was basically no one chatting. There was basically no one following me on Twitter, so no one really liked it. There was basically no one following my new YouTube channel, so again, there were no likes or barely any views. Like, I would get like 3 views or whatever for my videos. But keep doing that every day, you know, keep sharing a little bit every day, and eventually you're gonna get tons of likes. I'm doubting that's Box2D, because is Box2D, I don't think Box2D is deterministic, is it? So upper right would be greater than or equal to W2 and greater than or equal to H2. We'll be able to go south, southwest, and west. And then lower right. Pause.x. Yep, pause.y, less. So yeah, we'll be able to go north, northwest, and west. Yeah. Okay, so these are our possible directions depending on quadrant. Oh, if you keep the steps constant? Oh, right. Okay, cool. I didn't know that. I didn't know you could do keep it box duty deterministic. Oh, yeah. Nice, R2. Dude, that's cool that was a huge step for you and you did it. That took courage. It might seem like a not courageous thing to some people, but to you, that was hugely courageous. So good for you, dude. And I have a big recommendation for you. If you want to take this all to the next level and keep being more courageous and stuff, I wrote an article about tuning your mind. Can't even find it. But it's all about the same kind of thing, right? Getting past your fears, using your fears actually to propel yourself forward. Oh man, yeah, I know what you mean. Yeah, you're dude, I know what you I know. I know how you must feel right now. Yeah, Eklof, what's up, man? What's up, J-Yup? J I don't know how to say your name, man, but what's up? Yeah, I'm full time. Cellular. Whoa. Sweet. Oh, it's text-based. Oh, man, I love it already. Duh, it's so cool. Oh yeah, I know what you mean, man. Yeah. Check out that article, man. Check it out. And maybe it helps you, maybe it doesn't, but yeah. Yes, yeah. This is sweet. Dude, I'm breaking your like records like crazy. Look at this. This is sweet. I love how it's displacing the water. What's happening to the water over here, though? Oh, it's there. Oh, okay, I get it. It moves upward. Wow. This also could be a whole game. Cool, man. Yeah. Because I okay, I'm actually going to talk about this because this is really important. Before I ever started Songbringer, this was in November of last year, 2014. I had a lot of fears myself. In fact, I was incredibly afraid to share things online. Maybe for different reasons, but I don't know. You know, some people's reasons are similar and some people's reasons are not. But my reasons were that I was afraid someone was going to take my art style or the art I'd created, right? Because I had created all this mock-up art and I was like, okay, should I share this? Should I put it on Twitch? Because I bet you somebody's going to steal my character idea. Somebody's going to draw some dude with a top hat with his shirt off. And I was so afraid of that for such a long time. But then I started learning more about this, how to like challenge my own beliefs and stuff like that. So I challenged those beliefs. I just went on walks and I was finally like, you know what? It's totally silly. It's actually a irrational belief to believe that other people are going to steal my ideas because first of all, if somebody tries to take your idea, they're probably going, because your idea isn't fully developed, they're probably going to take that idea in a different direction than you would. It's like trees. You look at trees. They all kind of are similar in how they grow, right? A certain tree will always kind of grow the same, but no two trees are exactly the same. And I think ideas are kind of like seeds in that same sense. It's like you plant a seed in one person's brain and another person's brain, it's going to grow into two different looking trees. And it's all going to depend on how much soil there is and all that. So yeah, it's getting over your fears, you know? This is kind of what all that's about. Nice. This is another. Yes. Oh, what is this? This looks like medium.com, but it's not. Oh, cool. I can't wait to check this out. I'm gonna totally read this. This might be the same kind of thing I was talking. This totally reminds me of Medium. Is Medium like released their software or something now? Cool link, Ekloff. I have a feeling that's going to be a very cool read. Oh, really? Oh man. Oh man, I hope, dude, you got so much to unlock, dude. You're like so close. Whoa. Dude. Oh, because this is deterministic, that's how you created that logo that way? Sorry, I'm not actually reading all this. I'm just trying to like, yeah. Wow, dude. I agree. I agree. Whoa. Yeah. Yes. The Saros, totally right. Yeah. We all have our own fears, and they're all different and similar. Oh, so Lionhead Studios actually did this? Sorry, I didn't watch this one. Whoa. Liking, oh, bam. Yeah. Yeah, so cool. Releasing is like getting naked. Yeah. Oh God, this is a really good analogy, right? It totally is. Especially for us creators of software and games and game tools and all this kind of stuff. It's like, yeah, you really have to, it's you get vulnerable, you know what I mean? That's, oh man, it's such a, when you're actually in a vulnerable state, like I am right now sharing with you guys, and especially at the beginning when I first was sharing all these live streams, you're in a vulnerable state, and that is actually a very powerful state. You're teetering right between fear and like huge success, you know what I mean? And it's learning to put yourself in that fearful state but still be courageous, and you get amazing results, just like Mars was saying here. Yeah, totally. Yep. Yeah. All boils down to, right? What a great stream. I don't even want to code anymore. Yeah, what's up with that? Jeez. You're showing them your freaking beautiful artistic body, and they call the police? Doesn't even make sense. Yes, right? Yeah, Eklof, that's another fear that that is prevalent, especially in the circles that our types of people run in, you know what I mean? Intelligent, like game developers or gamers in general. It's you don't want to, yeah, this fear of being observed as dumb, unintelligent, or insert any kind of adjective that's similar to that type of person. And I hear you, man. I hear you. That's another reason why I kind of didn't share a song or didn't want to share Songbringer at first. I thought people would be like, oh my God, what a dumb plot. But it turns out that people like the plot for this game, you know? Oh my God, a guy that's looking for drugs. But people like that, you know? I feel like I wrote the dumbest plot ever, but people are liking it, so that's cool. Yeah. Culture can do that. Yeah, right? Yep. But it's our choice. It's our choice whether we believe the culture or not. But it is very hard when culture keeps on saying, oh, you're not good enough, or you're not good enough, or you're not good enough, or you're not good enough. Even if you think you are good enough, if you hear that you're not good enough a million times, you're gonna think it. You're gonna start thinking it. Unless you're really, really strong in your mind. And that's all that are all both those articles are about. I think that second article, but anyways, the article I wrote in there is about that, is about strengthening your mind. It's like Rick and Morty. Yes. I was just watching that last night. Yes. Yeah, 'cause you probably are. If you have a desire to say I'm really good at this or whatever, then you probably already are, and it's just that you want to admit it to yourself. You want to believe it, you know? Once you start believing it and you embrace it, then you get this. Yes, exactly. Yes. What's up, Lith? Welcome to the stream. We're having a crazy cool conversation about getting over fears, basically. And also we got to the same record for a number of BC Warriors in a row. We got nine in a row. That was pretty awesome earlier on the stream. Yeah. Whoa. Well, you know, little baby steps, man. Baby steps. Baby steps. Just reading those articles will put you on that path, you know, even if it, you know, baby steps. Oh yeah, that tweet was last night. So last night we got nine, and then on today's stream we got nine too, so we tied the record. But we were realizing that it stops from chatting. We were all like, oh, nobody wants to chat. Yeah. Yep. 'Cause you're never gonna know what other people actually think. So, what's the point of even wondering about what other people think? Oh, last night was eight. Oh, well, it's a new record. Yeah. Oh man, so cool. Yep. Yeah, I've always wondered this, but I have a feeling there's very few ladies that watch this stream. I don't know. I don't know. I may be wrong about that. If you're a lady, please say so. I'd love to know and not say guys all the time. Say you all. Right, yes. Oh, that's right. It was eight. Lighter Thief, what's up? Lighter Thief, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. He's just giving you crap. But anyways, yeah, we got this record for number of BC Warriors today, so almost tried to get another one, but it didn't get off the ground. You can't get them all off the ground. You can be a lady if you want. Well, apparently I need to wear this pink wig, so I'll look kind of like a lady too. What's up, Alex Pita? No. Don't listen to either of these guys. Don't listen to either of these guys. Day 230. Oh. Day 230 BC Warrior. I should do a BC Warrior chat where like the title is just BC Warrior, and if anybody ever chats anything other than BC Warrior, oh man, I know, right? Yeah, I gotta 10% devs too much. I gotta do something, right? I did get one bug already solved today, but let's get some more. Choose a direction. If this is not the old direction, so if dir is not equal to old dir, and we can use this direction. I need to do it. Yes, yeah, I gotta wear the wig. I gotta get the wig first. Yes, that's all you can type. Oh! You're eating through your nature box? What's that? I ruined it now. Will it be possible to get some access to some kind of debugger during the alpha? Probably not. There will be a dsim file, I think. I don't know. What is it that you're interested in debugging, or what was that, a Christmas tree? Oh, nice. Oh, cool. I didn't know there was such a thing as a nature box. Wow, they're only $20 too. Cool. So we need a function to be able to. Like, is allowed or something like that. Oh, the alpha's going really good, Ladder Thief. Yeah. I played it, I think yesterday. Yeah, yesterday I played through. Sunday I did a playthrough. And basically what I'm trying to do is get the get as many of these high priority items done as possible before the alpha is released. You taking off?
Mm-hmm. Hi, Steve.
Love you, buddy.
Love you too. Thanks for having me.
Yeah.
Cool.
Good times.
All right, brother. Bye. I'm trying to get as many of these done, and then so the alpha is actually coming out next Wednesday, no matter what, and yeah, so it's going really good. It is, right? Oh, okay, yeah. I mean, this you could just quit and just send me the save file. I mean, that would be a simple way of doing it, right? You could just save and exit the game and then send me that save file. What looks at you? Oh, the food? Oh. Yeah, so does that make sense? Like, wouldn't it be the same thing if you just go save and exit and then send me your save file? What's up, Ethan? Oh, yeah, I'm in a different room today. What's up, Z-Twitch? Oh, yeah, well, Ekloff, let me give you one thing you can do. So in your save file for the game, or in your settings file, so this will be, let me see if I can get it on Steam real quick. And I'll show you what you could do. Basically, all you want to do is this is allowed, right? Draw debug. This is kind of a this will give you a lot of insight into what's actually going on in the game. So if you turn on draw debug, you will probably have to add this to your settings file. So just add a line that says draw debug and capital D on the second for the debug, and then put it to 1. And this will really, really help. Could not connect to Steam. Anyways, this settings file is inside the package. You'll find it somewhere in there. It's contents, resources, or something like that. But yeah, just go into, this will be enabled for the release, this draw debug thing. So that might help. All right. I do have a lot of dropped frames today. This might be my internet screwing up or something today. So yeah, I'm gonna keep that off for now. It will? Okay, yeah. So let's get Songbringer. This is the old version, but I think it will still have. Everything. So yeah, I can show you where your settings file will be and your save file will be too. So yeah, this is how the alpha version is going to be distributed. So anybody that has access, you're going to get access or whatever. Just you enter your key. I think it's you go game, redeem something. Or activate a product on Steam, and that gives you access, and then you just open it up. Yeah, it might have been. So, and then you just go, where is it? I guess you just gotta go to properties. Oh yeah, you go properties, local files, and then browse local files. And that'll give you access to the actual folder. So once you're in here, you want to actually, if you're on Mac, you'll have to go show package contents on the songbringer.app. But if you're on Windows, this you actually have to go in here too, but this will be called songbringer.app, and it'll be a directory on Windows. But I'm putting both in the same kind of package, so it's really easy to get the game. So anyways, you go show package contents. Or just browse into the directory, and then it's contents, resources, assets. And this is where your settings file will be. I guess it's not there yet because I haven't run this old version. Let's run this old version once so we can see. This is the old one, so old. Oh. Oh, I can't even alt tab out right now. Sorry, guys. We gotta let this thing run for a second and save its game once so I can show you that file. Let's see. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Look how old it is. Oh wow, you even have the teleport cube in this version? All right, I should do it. Right? This has been decided. All right, so yeah, this is where the files will be. Contents, resources, assets, settings. Oh, it didn't save it there. It's called settings.txt now, but it used to be settings.plist. That's right. So yeah, settings.txt will be there, as well as everything else if you want to modify anything. And then saves.txt, I think, is going to be in this directory or something like that. But anyways. Even if it's hard. Lol. Here we go. So we need a function that says whether a certain direction is allowed. So bool compassdir allowed. So for give it a compassdir and give it some flags, and that will give you back whether that compass direction is allowed based on those flags. Oh right, yeah. Oh totally, that's a mind blower for sure. Yeah. Right? Yeah, they've been trying to make things easy for you. What's this? Oh, right. We didn't finish this yet, but... Right, this function, we're ready to do that. Get another one cross off the list. Okay, so K input allow south. No. Well, I did. How do I load the assets from Texture Packer in my game? Well, CocoStudioX does that for me, but basically, in CocoStudioX, it's as easy as just going one. It's a one-liner. Where's it at? Yeah, you call sprite frame cache, get instance, and then you go add sprite frames with file, and you give it the plist file for that sprite sheet, and it loads them all and processes them, puts them into the sprite frame cache, and then it's really easy to get frames from the sprite frame cache. That's it. That's all there is to it. I also have a script which runs every time the game compiles. There's a script. Script? Yeah, it's just script. So this will go and update all the sprite sheets. So for each one of my sprite sheet files, it goes and runs Texture Packer. And if Texture Packer finds no differences in any of the ping files, it doesn't do anything. So this is safe to run anytime you want. And so if a ping file has been updated, it just runs it and boom, you're done. So yeah. Right? Yeah. So CocoStudioX does this in the background for us, basically, with Coco in their scheme. Right. VRAM. Yep. What's up, Blood? What's up? Welcome, man. We've been having a crazy cool stream today. Oh yeah. So this whole k input allow south, that's just a straight up enum. So this is pretty easy. This function's simple. If search return flags and dir shifted up one. No, wait. One shifted up dir. So input allow south is one. One shifted up zero is one. Yeah. Okay, and then the compass direction south is zero. So one shifted up zero will be one. Yeah, this should work. Compass dir allowed. Cool. Yeah, I heard about that. Doing great, man. Oh, really? Cool, dude. Nice. So allowing this direction based on e dot input dot flags, I think. Yeah, e dot input flags. Yeah. What's up, Artemis? I'm working on fixing some bugs for the alpha version coming out next week. Have you seen this game before? Oh yeah, you can see the bugs list. It grows and it shrinks every day. So I'm right. I was down really low on my high priority list, and then I played the game, and I'm like, oh my god, there's so many more things. But yeah, so this is the list. This is the goal, to get this stuff done by Wednesday, next Wednesday. And I also have a lot of marketing to do, which is like, that's like 1 or 2 days is just going to be marketing. So I've really have got to get these things done like this weekend, or maybe just do the work marketing this weekend. I don't know. So yeah. Yeah. I know. I love to see it disappear too. What is it? What does what mean? Oh, match three. You're asking about match three. Oh, yeah. Uranus. Good one. Artemis, let me show you the game really quick. This game's called Songbringer. I think I can run this without building. Let's hope that we can. Oh, yeah, I'm in this room with these guys. Okay, so yeah, this is Songbringer. It's like Zelda 1, but it's procedurally generated. So when you start your adventure in this game, you enter 6 letters, and those 6 letters give you an entire world. It generates the whole world. Whoa, check it out, bomb container. Free room. Nice. So this is it. Yep, it's a lot like, it's just like Zelda 1. So there's an overworld, and there's also levels. So I'm in a level right now, but there's actually overworlds too, or like areas. Here, I can show you. So yep, and it's only about 60% done or so. This game has a long ways to go, or at least a third to go. So this is kind of what it's like. There you go. There's tons of items too. So there's like that shows you where the first level is in this screen. There's bombs. There's a top hat. You can throw your top hat. You can shoot your sword and get these sword powers. You can get blink power, so you can teleport forward a few steps. There's lots of cool items. What's up, Jewelstrom? Yeah, I am. Yep. Yeah, I do the code, I do the art, I do the music, I do the marketing. It's a one man thing, and I hope this is a big inspiration too. So, I really that was kind of my goal for doing these Twitch streams and also for archiving them all on YouTube is for people to be able to look back and go, whoa, one guy made this whole game and I can do it too. I hope this is an inspiration for you because really, you can. You don't have to be part of a team to make a cool game. Yes, I'm the only one. Yay, right on. Good. Nice. Yes. Mission accomplished. Inspiration. Okay, so I'm working on this item right now in my high priority items is enemies can sometimes get stuck on the walls, sort of. They keep on walking towards the walls like idiots. So the goal is to make them smarter in how they process their input and stuff. Right on. Thanks, man. How to prepare iOS Xcode later this semester. Prepare for it. You're making Android apps. You found it difficult. Okay. I would agree. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. I do have some advice for you. First of all, go get Xcode. And yeah, start doing some simple projects. Go do like an Xcode tutorial. Like search YouTube for it. And just do the simplest tutorials you can, do the simplest projects. And yeah, but first of all, just get Xcode. It's really easy. Just start using it. And do simple iOS apps and stuff like that. Do the simplest tutorials. But that will probably help out a lot to prepare you for your next semester. I do have some old videos with the beard. Yes, I use a game engine. It's called Cocos 2DX. It's a great engine, but it's very open sourcey, so it's a very do-it-yourselfy kind of game engine. Yeah, November, Marzo's game launch. Small space game, cool. Yeah, like FTL. Sweet. Oh, cool, man. Just want to zoom in. Oh, cool. So these are like control tables and stuff. Nice, man. I can't wait to see you fill this up with stuff. So cool. Awesome, Ekloff. Oh. Any suggestions for learning procedural generation? Yeah. First of all, what kind? Do you want to do 2D, 3D? What kind of procedural generation are you talking about? But let me start getting you a link that's probably going to help. MetaZelda. Here you go. I recommend this one. This is what I use to 2D. Yeah, cool. Then you're too. Check this out. Check out that and a lot of his other articles on here. It does. But I somehow disabled that or something like that. I forget. Nice, Eklof. Oh, damn. Don't think it's gonna fly right now. Yeah, it's a great page. And then also, oh, you gotta check out this is no, I don't, I'm not gonna really give you this link, but I guess so. Red Blob Games is another great one for two game tutorials and stuff like that. There's too much to say. It's too much to say. Can I just copy that? Oh, you can. You could copy paste them. Wow. What? What? Oh, no. Nice. You guys did it on purpose, didn't you? No worries. I'll get my work done tonight or whatever. This is a great... No. No. Do not ban. You wouldn't... You promise. No, don't even ban yourself. Can you ban yourself? I know. But we have this already. Check it out. World record. 9 in a row. Right here at the beginning of the stream. Everybody got quiet. Really quiet. It was great. We'll do one. We'll do it again at some point. We'll get 10. I don't know if today's the day, though. I know, dude, a Pierre emoji would be great. Apparently, if you become a Twitch partner, you can make your own emojis. But that takes, like, a lot of viewers and stuff. We're talking, like, thousands, I think. So we'll see. We'll capture older in this little method. We can reuse this to push back directions a lot smarter. Oh, we also need flags. There, this method should be good. A 40 combo? What? That would be awesome. Deal. Yeah. Pita. Yeah, Jolstrom, but don't worry about it, man. Don't worry if you're using old stuff. The point isn't to use the when you're first getting used to like Xcode or any type of IDE or whatever. It doesn't really matter if you're using old code because the goal is to get used to the software. Just get used to the IDE, how it works, you know? It's not to have perfect concepts and be a perfect coder or whatever. So, yeah, just don't worry about that. You can? How do you do that? What's up, Boogie? Ladyliners, really? Really? Dude. Yeah, scenery change. I'm in a different room today. Sure you can. Yeah, nice, nice. The naming dilemma. Yeah, yeah, but like I said, it's really not the point, isn't to use. It doesn't matter whether you're using deprecated methods when you're first learning Xcode or any kind of software. It's just to get used to it, you know. Really? Zatrick, what's up, man? The alpha build's coming out next Wednesday. Sorry, it's taken longer than I thought to get all these bugs off the list, but that's just because that's how game development goes. What? You can? You can submit emotes. Oh, I'm going to submit a jib emote. Oh, so sweet. Nice, dude. Oh, the design. Oh, right on. Yep, yeah. Yep, so I've been basically working every day on this high priority list, and every day it shrinks a little bit, and sometimes it grows a little bit too, because I've been playing the game, and then I play the game and find bugs and stuff, so yeah, this is kind of a constant flux, but it's getting closer and closer to being ready. Yeah, jib. Jib, jib. Oh, whoa. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, I will. Sad whiz, happy whiz. Shy whiz. All right. Yeah, see, there you go. Yeah. Stone whiz, yes. Oh, I could do that one really good. But only at nighttime. I'm telling you, if I smoke weed in the day, the whole day is ruined. I can't code. Maybe it's just lately. I don't know. But yeah. Man, I love weed. I love it. BC Wiz. Yes. Yes. Pink hair. There, much better methods, simpler, safe. It's only adding directions we're going to use. Oh, you have to have the extension installed. All right, Wes. That's not too hard. You know, because I would install it. I'm sure some of you would too. So then. Oh, text message alert. All right. Okay, you know what? I'll do it first for my phone, then I'll totally like, I even put this as a high priority item. No, I can't make it a high priority, but I can make it a low priority. All right, one of these days I'm gonna surprise you guys with this soon. Yeah, yeah. So if you don't have the extension installed, then it appears as text, right? I'm assuming. So if you don't have it installed, it would be like that, and you just see the text. Oh, man. South, south. Oh, this is wrong. Northwest and west. And then we can just choose a direction from the random. What's up, Zeith? This is what Zeith thinks about all this. What's up, Zeith? What's up, man? Oh no, oh no! Oh, right, right. So, yeah, if we got possible direction, I guess we are going to have to fall back. Ensure we have a direction. So, if possible size is less than or equal to 0, then push one back. Possible push back random compass direction based on the flags that we have available for this character. There, and now we've guaranteed that we at least have a possible direction, so we can choose one at random. E.ai.dir equals possible drand possible dot size. Oh, I finally wrote this function. I've been writing this function for like 45 minutes or something. Whoa. So crazy today. No, don't ban. Oh, I haven't seen this one. Who's this? Cougar Hunt? All right, let's see if this worked. Finally, we're going to run the game again. What if there's no directions? Possible, you mean? I mean, yeah, that's what I did push back that one for. I pushed one back to guarantee it. But yeah, this will work. I guess it would be pragmatic. It would be very, very pragmatic to just go if possible dot size. It's greater than 0. Yeah. That's worth having in there, I think. What? Yay, Pierre! Nice red eyes, dude. Nice. Sorry, I hope. Oh my god. I hope I'm not somebody's nightmare tonight. Please don't let me be a nightmare. Oh. That's hilarious. So we need to submit that. What's up, Gein? What's up, DuPont? Berensteel? Okay, let's watch these guys and see if they... Yeah, okay, that guy didn't get stuck on the edge. Whoa, that guy was really smart there. So, yeah, if anybody's just joining the stream, you're like, what's he doing right now? I did this new bit of code, which it was supposed to make it so that the enemies never really get stuck on the edge. I think that was okay, because what that guy did is he walked up and down, and that's okay if you're at that point, that quadrant. Yes! Okay, that's one issue. See that guy walking on the right over there? He really got stuck there for a while, going straight north, straight south. But that would be only in a room like this, where there's a short bit of distance that an enemy could get stuck in right here. This is something that I've left purposely ambiguous. So you have no clue whether he has two eyes or one eye or he has sunglasses or whatever, but I think I'm going to kind of reveal that at some point. So I don't know. I personally don't know what he's got underneath there. Really? Yes, yes. Oh, I saw this movie. This is a great movie. What's it called again? Nice. Are these random every time you load it or something? Oh, right, yeah. Really? Position changes, huh? Yeah. Oh, there's fire now? Yeah, got the yellow bell pepper, got the garlic. Oh, for the knives. You mean the knives have position changes? Oh, dude, it's so funny how he gets chopped into pieces of, like, sliced mushrooms. Good job, lad. Nice progress. Plot twist, he's blind. Wow. Dude, Jonah. That is a cool plot twist. I might do that. You've been coming up with some crazy cool ideas over the time. Interesting idea. I'm gonna definitely toss that one around. Which movie was that? Oh yeah. Okay, so it was this movie about I think this movie was about movie with Andy Samberg and Kit Harington. 7 days in Hell. Yeah, it's 7 days in Hell. This is hilarious. If you gotta see this movie. Yeah. Yes. Kind of a downer? I don't know. Possibly. Depends on the context. Oh. It probably is. That's a great one. Double plot twist. He isn't blind. He just doesn't realize he can open his eyes. He doesn't even have eyes. Now that's interesting. He is alien. I'm gonna go ahead and delete all the rest of this code because that was kind of cool. I'm liking this. Let's try it out on a different screen. Maybe this one. 111. Oh, maybe that. Oh. Huh. Oh, yeah. He's only a figure in a video game. So at the end of the game, you're playing this game and you realize that he is actually a game within the game. Or he's only a character with. That's crazy. Okay, so I'm basically just checking if these guys are going to get stuck and how they're going to perform. Now, this is a good area to test because, yeah, see what happened there? That guy walked along that wall for a second, but he didn't go back and forth because... Huh. Yeah, this is better. This is much better. These guys are actually staying far, far closer to the center of the screen. This is going to really help them seem smarter. Cool. That's a good bug fix. I like this. He's the one programming me. Oh my God! Now that would be that's definitely a brain melter. You were only imagining playing the game. There's no game. On Rock's home planet, sunglasses are just an accessory. You don't have eyes. You just wear sunglasses if you're cool. Right. So he doesn't have eyes. Yeah. Cool. Dude, good thoughts, you guys. This is really going to... I don't know this will all turn out to be like, but it's so cool to have your guys' suggestions. Finding a cave. Right? Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Did I write this one down? I thought I wrote it down, but I'll write it down again, even if it's not, because that'd be funny. That'd be a funny Easter egg. Yeah, Soma. Yeah, I saw some videos. Anton Kudin was sharing some videos, and I was looking at it. But yeah, is it for is it for Steam? Sells 92,000 copies. Yeah. Oh, it is on Steam. Cool. Enter my birth date. Let me put this one on my wish list. I'm wishing. What's up, Mind Sanity? How do you learn Swift? I don't know, man. I haven't learned Swift myself. I would recommend some tutorials. It's exactly how you imagined it at the start. Oh, his eyes are not yet used to it. Interesting one. What Mac am I using? I'm using a MacBook Pro. 2013 late model Retina. It's great. Love it. Yeah, right? Ira Kogan? That's how expensive those kind of games are. Really? A dirty language version that will be unlocked only if you complete the game? Oh, if you've completed once, it has a dirty language version? Yeah. It's a cool idea. Cool. I like that. I've wanted to have something like that. Something where you've completed the game once and it unlocks something, right? So let's do one more room and make sure that this is still working. Maybe some Ra's enemies we can check out. Maybe a lot of them in level 9 or something. Maybe Ra's. Here we go. 508. Let's go there. Just make sure this is working for all types of enemies, including bats. I should do a bat room. Yeah. If you play the co-op, characters will flirt with each other. Yeah, it is, man. That's how people stream games. An Axis Inverter object. What's up, Jimmy? Yeah, I probably will. But yeah, this is already going to be kind of a content rating high game. Temporarily. Oh, yeah, that's a cool item. Let me add that. Right, so that was like you could get some whiskey or something like that, like some scotch or some whiskey. What's up, PMC? Fake diamonds? Cool. Interesting. So could you collect fake diamonds? Like you would have a bunch of fake diamonds, like you'd have a you could up get like 10 or 20. Yes, yeah, I could stream a game. That's what I'm doing right here with this game. Oh, good. Right on. Ah, so wait, it's would it take away your diamonds or something? Yeah, I know. This the cactus is like a definite would be an obvious one for that, right? Okay, these Roz guys aren't the best ones to test for this because they don't wander around as much. But what's up here? Are these guys stuck? These guys are totally stuck on each other. Okay, good thing I checked this. Now they're all stuck. Because they only have one possible direction they can go in. Wow. Okay, that kind of failed. Let's make sure that let's fix this. It's a very important piece of code here. Choosing the random direction when an enemy gets stuck. So let me undo this, and there's got to be something which... Yeah, I'm in a new room today. We had a guest today, so I was in this room today. They turn into a foe when you try and get it. Right? Hardcore mode? What's up, Scorched Yeti? Any idea where you can what more? Learn more or get more? Mindsanity, yes, this game is in C++. The game engine I'm using is called Coco Studio X. And yes, I do all the animations, all the art, all the music, all the sound effects, all the code, and all the marketing and everything. Yep. All right, yeah, so, right, back to square one, with you mean with this whole enemies? Let's watch what their directions are actually doing. Debug mode. Yeah, no, we already got that. It's called permadeath. Oh, you mean when you die, you never play the game again? I do all the bugs. That's right. Yeah. Okay, so let's let these guys get stuck. And then we'll watch their directions. See, the thing is, there we go. This is probably going to lead to them getting stuck right here. Yeah, they're totally going to get stuck. Let's go over here. We're trying to track these flies away so we can see what directions. Yeah, see that? He's flickering between direction 0 and 2. 0, 2, 0, 2, 0, 2. That's why he's getting stuck. So it's almost like they need to keep track of their last direction. That might work. How do I avoid being distracted from my work? On the live stream, I don't even try, man. But that's why I only live stream for like 2 hours a day. So that I get the rest of the 8 hours that day or whatever to just keep coding and coding and coding and being focused and all that. When you die, the game is auto uninstalled and your Steam key is revoked. Wow. Enable mirror mode? What's mirror mode? And your PC bursts into flames? Yeah, yeah. I mean, well, you guys already know there's already permadeath mode, but yeah. So hardcore is even more difficult than permadeath. Wait, so what's mirrored? Oh, axis inverted. Oh, okay. Right, right. Oh, but you're saying that it's the same world but flipped. Yeah. Okay, so what could I guess we could have a last direction on each of these AI. Let's try that. AI component. We could give it a last direction. So compass direction dir and laster, so that when we're doing a random direction, we can make sure that it doesn't ever choose the last random direction either. Yeah, that would eventually get them out of their loop, because they would probably not have any directions from the three directions, and then they would get a random one. So dir equals last dir equals kdir none. This, we do need to do it again here. But that's it. Yeah, just those. That'll initialize that. Yeah. Yeah, but he's not. Yeah, I get what you guys are both saying. And you die too? Yeah. Really interesting. Yeah, Cocos the DX doesn't have a function to explode your computer yet, but I'm sure we could work that out. Oh, that would be crazy. What's up, Slow Excellence? Okay, so system. This is where we change an AI's direction. If changed, eta move to last compass dir. Oh, actually, we want to go before we ever change the direction. E.ai.laster equals E.ai.dir. And then, so when we push these directions, we want to make sure we don't ever push, whoops. We're gonna capture both these. And if dir is not equal to old dir 1, dir is not equal to old dir 2, and that. So that should probably do it. That's all we really need to do. I hope this works. It's a plugin. It's easily installable. Explode your computer! Sorry, man. Yeah, I know what you're saying, though. Some languages, right? But just don't look at the code, then. All right, so let's see if these guys get stuck all together in that pile again. They shouldn't. But I'll try and attract them to that same position by standing here. Yeah, there's a position where they totally should get stuck, but they don't. Nice. Okay, we can turn off debug mode and check it in a more, like, visual manner. Just watch them. These guys stuck? Don't get stuck. Get out of it. Oh, man, they're still stuck. What's up with that? That should have worked. Right? Yeah. Why not? Let's eat some diamonds. I don't know. What's up, AI glitch? Yeah, right? Cash it. What's up, man? Cool idea. You can see where other people died when playing the same seed. Man, that would be cool. I would have to do so much work to make that happen, but it would be server work. I'd have to create a server that would keep track of all that and then allow the game to connect to the server and all that. But it's such a cool idea. I'm going to add it to the list. I like that, right? Seeing where other people died. Maybe there'd be gravestones or something like that that would represent where somebody else died. That's cool. I like that. Thank you for sharing, man. You're right. Nice. I like that too. Yeah. This is something I would have to do different armor and different effects and stuff like that. So, I mean, I've always had the idea of adding armor, so maybe I will add that to the whole game. This should be happening. We should be getting that. When they get stuck. Let's see if that happens. All right, Marza. Good night, man. Cheers. Good chatting with you. Yeah, see, they're not getting this, they're not hitting this breakpoint at all. And now their AI is even totally stuck. They're not doing anything. Okay, well, what next? So I've just confirmed that the problem is it's not getting that, but older one, older two, pushters. Yeah, all that seems quite reasonable. That's how it should be. What? What? Oh. 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 How many is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We got 10! This is a world record. Somebody else. Come on. We can go higher than this. 11, 12, 13, perhaps. Come on. Anybody else that's watching the stream, you know what to do. You know what to do. Just type capital B, capital C, capital W, Warrior, BC Warrior. Yes, chocolate beer. Oh, Marza. Marza, we almost had like 13. Oh, how many is that? I gotta take a screenshot. Oh, just sorry to take a screenshot. Oh, I missed it again. Hey. Oh, there. That's how I do it. There. Dude. Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11. Oh, man. That was 11, though. I'm posting that on Twitter. Yes, day 230. We'll have an epic one, I'm sure. It's not worth it if it's not spontaneous. Good point. Good point. See you, Marza. Oh, wait. What if there's only one direction that they can go in? Yeah, that's probably what is going on, right? Because this AI gets in a state where it only has one direction it can move in, which is either, you know, like if it's there in that, say, so those guys were getting stuck in sort of the upper right and the lower right quadrants. So they were getting either south, southwest, or west. And so southwest is not going to be allowed for these types of entities. So it's either south or west. It can't go west because that's the last direction it moved in, but it can go south, it thinks. And then, yeah, so basically, I think this will work if I set this to less than or equal to 1. Let's see if that works. Oh, no! Alex Pita! Good night, man. What's up, TM Game Dev? I should have just ended the stream right then. Nice, right on, man. Welcome to the stream. It's been an epic stream today. I'm getting close to about finished with today's stream, though. But yeah, thanks for joining, man. Thanks for saying hi. Welcome, welcome. I'm working on alpha bug fixes and stuff. Okay. So what's happening right now, I'm trying to get enemies so they're a little smarter and they don't get stuck. And they still don't get stuck on walls. Yeah, that worked, I think, that time. And they never got stuck before. It's just that they would sometimes run against the wall over and over and over like idiots. And so the point is to make them so they don't run against the wall. I think that's working. Yeah, right on. Cool. Cool. Okay, I gotta try that one more time to see if they do actually get stuck, and then I gotta try it another time on this other level. Here. Do they? They should have right there. They would have right there. Whoa. Okay, so there's one other place I want to check. Yes, yeah, Boogie, I've actually made several of my sound effects in this game with Befixer. I love it. Yeah, these guys are kind of eyeball inspired. They're sort of like demonic eyeballs or something. So this other level had some other guys that are good to test. Yeah, well, they're not really that hard. I do need to increase their difficulty because that was level 8. They should have been harder. And I need to write more enemies. So, like I said, there's so many more enemies to add to this game. and bosses, and that's pretty much the next like 3 or 4 months is going to be almost all enemies and bosses, because they take a while to create good ones, you know. So yeah, you're right, they're not that hard. They need to be smarter and a little more difficult, a little more health, better attack, stuff like that. And my goal is to make them so their difficulty can increase as you increase the level. So as you, like at level 1, enemies are not going to be that smart, not as difficult. But the same enemy at level 9 would be really hard. Okay, so he did kind of get stuck there on that wall for a second, but he got out of it pretty quickly. All right, so yeah, I think that's it for today's stream. This is looking pretty good. Yeah, yeah, they will definitely become more difficult to beat. Yep. So yeah, that's it for today's stream. Got some stuff done. We had a lot of fun today. It was great. Got two world records for a number of BC Warriors in a row. But yeah, if anybody's curious, like, what the heck is this? This game's called Songbringer. It's a Zelda-like game, procedurally generated, coming out in January on Steam. So good night, you guys. Had a great time with you. Thanks for everything.